The countries of the former Yugoslavia are as diverse as they are beautiful. From the walled city of Dubrovnik, look out over the Adriatic Sea before journeying inland to Sarajevo, Zagreb, and the aquamarine waters of the Plitvice Lakes. In Optija, walk along a seaside path to discover the maiden with the seagull. Then cycle your way through Ljubljana, one of the greenest cities in Europe. Near Zagreb, Sister Berisava describes life as a nun in the Baroque castle Ljubljana and the spiritual mission she shares with her fellow sisters. Historian Marica Lojan shares her experience of meeting one of her childhood role models, former Yugoslavian President Josip Broz Tito. Chef Damir Podboj reminisces on a childhood spent in the kitchen with his mother and grandmother.
Ovaj breg je dobio naziv po legendi o Veronici Desiničkoj koja se događala u srednjem vijeku kad se grof iz Velikog Tabora zaljubio u našu seljanku pučanku Veroniku Desiničku. Pa evo, odrastanje u našem lijepom Zagorju ovdje kraj Velikog Tabora bilo je prekrasno. Tu smo se igrali puno puta na livadama, vinogradima, oko nas, brali grožđe, brali kukuruze, pekli. Pa zagorska kuhinja se zasniva na, kako bi rekli, siromašnijim jelima, jer prije nije bilo tolika ponuda plodova, ali sve što je izraslo ovdje u našim krajevima, livadama, sve se iskorištavalo na više načina. I to je ono izvorno domaća zagorska kuhinja. Strast za kuhanje je počelo već od malenih dana kad smo morali pomagati mami i baki, donositi plodove iz vrta, čistiti, pripremati dok su one radile završni dio i onda smo normalno i kasnije uživali u tom jelu. Pa evo, supruga i Jasna i ja smo počeli to, kao što sam rekao, 96. Uživamo u nuđenju ljudima naših proizvoda koje sami proizvodimo ovdje u našoj kuhinji, od naše zimnice, od naših raznih pečenja, štrudli, i to smo prenijeli na sinove Marka i Matiju koji sad isto rade dalje i isto tako prenose te delicije gostima.
Dear guests, welcome to our restaurants and I want a pleasant meal.
Bon appétit.
It's very hard to explain it, how you decided something to be in your life, because those reasons are deeply emotional and spiritual. That's something that I felt attracted to this way of life since I was 15. But I entered convent when I was 24, so I had 9 years to decide, to ask myself many questions, to wait. And when I finished my study, I was sure it's my way. Lužnica castle is a Baroque castle built in the 18th century by rich and powerful family Rauch, that had an interesting and unusual change in its history when in 1925 was bought by sisters. Sisters bought it as a house big enough for a large number of sick and old sisters they had to give them proper treatment here. And the other reason that they bought Lužnica were fields around it where they produced food for hospital they had in Zagreb. So Lužnica became convent for 80 years. Now Lužnica has a new mission. In 2007 we opened it as a spiritual educational center. What's a mission of Lužnica is to provide a place where people will feel loved by God and by humans. Very important task that we have here is a possibility of resocialization of a former drug addict. They come from commune, searching for a new life, so we gave them possibility to work for a few years here as a gardeners. But it's possibility to a new start, somewhere else, to not to go back to their former environment.
Dobar dan, ja sam Marica Lojen, živim ovdje u Kumrovcu, rođena sam u Klajncu, a inače živim tu u blizini Kumrovca, malo selo koje se zove Gornji Škrnik. Kumrovec je poseban u čitavom svijetu jer se u Kumrovcu nalazi rodna kuća Josipa Broza Tita i jer je čitavo selo, etno selo, dakle sačuvan je oblik sela kako je bilo u vrijeme njegovog rođenja. Dok je bio živ, mir je bio u ovim prostorima, a gledao je i šire od Hrvatske, od Jugoslavije, želio mir u čitavom svijetu. U vrijeme Tita bilo je puno dobrih stvari, lijepo se je živjelo, radnici su dobivali plaću za svoj rad. Bilo je posla, bilo je mogućnosti školovanja, obrazovanja koje je bilo besplatno, bilo je besplatno zdravstveno osiguranje. To su velike mogućnosti, mislim da su ljudi mogli pristojno živjeti. Svake godine je netko bio određen tko će predati zadnji štafetu Titu u Beogradu. Da će Hrvatska dati nositelja štafete, da će to biti učenik 7. razreda. Po tome sam imala šanse. U mojoj školi mene su predložili jer sam bila pionir, a bila sam dijete iz čiste seljačke obitelji. Dakle, mama i tata živjeli su od poljoprivrede, bilo slično obitelji Josipa Broza. To je bio razlog. Jer nisam znala zašto su me pozvali. Radosno sam odgovorila, kako ne bi.
After Croatia declared independence from Yugoslavia in 1991, Zagreb was proclaimed the capital of this newly formed nation. Zagreb was initially settled in the Roman times.
Zagreb holds a lot of surprises for the newcomers. It's a beautiful modern city. It is something different that you never experience all through Croatia, with a vibe like this and with the people like this.
There are numerous myths around the origins of the name Zagreb. Many believe that the name Zagreb was derived from the term Zabreg, or beyond the hill. Based on early etymology, it is likely that this hill is the bank of the river Sava. Reaching a staggering height of 354 feet, the Gothic spires of the Cathedral of the Assumption can be seen from many corners of the city, making this cathedral an icon of Zagreb. From Dubrovnik to Zagreb to Optia to Ljubljana, the countries and cities of the former Yugoslavia offer a myriad of landscapes and opportunities. A distant land where cascading lakes inspire a magical scene. And villages stand as proof that with enough ambition, even the smallest of us can make a difference. Tread the crossroads of these countries once united under the flag of Yugoslavia. Along the eastern shore of the Adriatic, from Croatia to Montenegro and Albania, lies the Dalmatian coast. From the Romans to Napoleon, this region has been a target of conquest and obsession for empires throughout the ages. Korčula, one of more than 1,300 islands in the Adriatic, is home to Mihovil de Polo. From his ancestral home, he restores the ancient works of art that made Korčula famous. And Irena Kaštela, who makes her living as her grandfather did, from the bounty of the sea. You may meet Darko Lozica, who steadfastly dances the island's traditional Moreška war dance.
Mnogi znaju kaza za Morešku da je to ples koji simbolizira borbu između dobra i zla. Međutim, naši stručnjaci, pogotovo doktor folklora Ivan Ivančan iz Zagreba, on kaže Moreška je borba za djevojku. A što je najvažnije, mi u Korčuli imamo jednu posebnu atrakciju, to je naša viteška igra. Moreška, s kojom smo jako, jako ponosni i ja se posebno dičim njome jer sam u toj igri učestvovao pre dvije godine sam slavio 2000 nastupa, a danas ima otprilike 2100, a isto tako počeo sam batit Morešku prije 67 godina. I mislim da je važno da je njegujemo, jer imamo na Jadranskoj obali mnogo mjesta veličine Korčule, malo više, malo manje, ali niko nema takvu atraktivnu priredbu kao što je Moreška. Prema tome, mi je moramo i dalje njegovati, jer to u našem turizmu predstavlja značajan moment reklame grada.
My early childhood, they told me that instead of playing with the dolls as any other ordinary girl, I used to play with the tubes. I knew when I was approximately 7-8 years old that I want to continue what my grandfather started.
Romans believed that coral could cure snake bites. But today, this brilliant colonial creature of the Adriatic is celebrated for its form and colorful beauty.
As I said before, again here, we have silver 95, and we have coral that is cut on the old way.
Oh.
Like the ones, if you remember from before, the ones yes. From the back.
Yes.
You can hold this one, just okay. Look and have a look at it.
In my family, everybody is a jeweler. My grandfather was a jeweler, my father, my two brothers. So I'm the first woman who entered the family business 25 years ago.
Now this lapislazuli is a precious stone, diamond cut of a stone. The highest quality lapislazuli comes from Afghanistan. Here you have the highest quality coral and
I feel blessed I have a chance to continue the family tradition and to run the shop because that was my desire all my life.
I always wanted to come back in my hometown because my family is here. Life in Korčula is more spontaneous and easier. I spend less time in traffic because I have my workshop in my house. I have more time.
for myself and for my family. I grew up in a historical environment. I was surrounded by historical artifacts, so the restoration of art was a natural thing for me.
Mihofil shares a name with Korčula's most famous export, the explorer Marco Polo.
There are some facts connecting Marco Polo to Korčula. For example, he was buried in a part of Venice where only people from Dalmatia were living. And of course, members of Polo family lived here in Korčula in 13th century. We have documents proving that.
After spending time in Dubrovnik, the pearl of the Adriatic, take some time to meet the people of Gromača. There, you'll find Keti Margaretic and her family.
Bavimo se sa svime pomalo. Loze, maslina, voća I povrća. Stoke, krave, ovce, prace, kokoši.
This is the smokehouse for people on the This is the smokehouse for them. You can see the left kitchen. We are smoking pashut, ham, bacon, sausage, legs, and head. We pick actually the whole meat from pigs.
You speak beautiful English. Did you learn that in school?
Mm-hmm. Yes. In my generation, we started fourth grade in elementary school to learning English. Same like my daughter, she's fine health and she do English better than now my mother or father. I just tell her a few times something, she's remembered that. But mom and dad, I tell them a few times and then you're screaming because you know, father says, my head is full. I don't have place for remember something else. So, I think that you are right, that you are hungry, and because dinner is waiting, everything is at table, then so yes, we can right. Move to another room to have a dinner.
At the Margaretic home, share a meal prepared from the meat, vegetables, and fruit of their farm.
Okay. Živjeli.
Lijepo je razmijeniti iskustva s ljudima drugoga kraja svijeta. Oni nešto nauče nas, a mi nešto njih.
On your journey down the Dalmatian coast. From Croatia to Montenegro, Albania to Greece. You'll find what makes this region so special? The people who call it home.